Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Wright-Patt Credit Union's Finances in Focus Live. My name is Ivy, and we'll just give a little bit of time to allow some folks to get on. Excited to come share with you on this lovely Thursday around 7 of my tips to help with back-to-school shopping, especially in these uncertain times. So we'll be starting in just a second. Again, I'm going to share with you 7 of my favorite tips to help with back to school shopping, but specifically during these uncertain times. So if you have children, if you know someone that has children, if you have grandchildren, please share this message right now. I'll just give a few moments to allow everybody to hop on, and then we'll jump right in. Those of you that are like me, we are, you know, trying to figure out not only the best decision to make in regards to sending our kids to school, but number 2 on the list is, what are they gonna need to be successful? And so at the credit union, we just wanted to take a few minutes to come on and share a few tips around that topic. So again, please feel free to share. I'm actually going to share this myself, and feel free also to comment so that I know that you're here. I am excited to be here. And second, again, if you're on now, feel free to share, feel free to say hello, and we'll go ahead and just wait in just a few moments. So again, today we're talking about a couple of tips to help you in getting back to school on a budget, with on purpose and with what you need. So going to share with you just a couple of my tips. I have 7 to help us during these times. A couple of them are back to school in general, and then a couple have to do with back to school in times of uncertainty. There's some specific things in this pandemic environment that you as parents may be navigating. So we're going to take a look at that. So the first thing I want to share with you, when we're thinking about headed back to school, is to make sure that you take inventory of what you already have first, right? How many times do we get these back to school lists, and instead of taking a look at what maybe our children already have in the book bag from last year, or maybe what you have tucked away in storage, we just run out, we grab the list, and we get started from scratch each and every time. Well, likely, especially because many of you had children who came home unexpectedly and finished the whole school year unexpectedly at home, you may have some items that will fulfill the school list needs this year that you could carry over from previous years. So I encourage you, as my first tip, is to, yes, take a little bit of time and take inventory about what you already have around the house that could fulfill the needs that you have on your school supplies list. Do you have a few pencils that haven't been sharpened? Maybe you have a pack of paper that wasn't completely used. I know in my home, we always open a pack and then we never finish it. Maybe you have some folders that can be either recycled and reused or that you didn't pull out. Take inventory on what you have, see what you can pull from to already fill that list. And again, especially because many of our children came home unexpectedly, they may have some items in their book bag that they just stuck in the closet and didn't think about again. So check with them on that. My second tip for you would be to shop in small quantities this year. I know there are a lot of sales going on. I know that there are a lot of sales going on, and that it could be a little bit challenging to want to go out and really shop and big and buy a whole bunch of supplies while it's on sale. And that is an option, but consider shopping small to start. Start off with just what you small quantities of maybe what you need, and then a little bit extra, because we are in these uncertain times. And if your child is in a school that is going back in an in-person environment, we're not sure what that may look like over the coming weeks. So start small, shop for the necessities only. Don't feel like you have to, get a whole wardrobe of clothing. If your children are virtual, they won't necessarily be noticed on how many outfits they're wearing in a day as they might be if they were in person. So consider shopping small and smaller quantities and focusing on the necessities as a way to kind of navigate your budget with it. However, if you plan to purchase in bulk, which is typically one of my tips, I typically recommend purchasing in large amounts and actually saving some for mid-year. But if you plan to purchase in bulk this year, see if you can go in partnership with another parent or another family to purchase certain items in bulk and then split the items out. That's one way that you can maximize the items that you have, but also keep your budget on track and share in the difference. Speaking of shopping, my next tip would be, if you are going to shop, make sure that you're taking advantage of deals. Make sure that you're getting the best bang for your buck. Look for stores that are offering sales on their resources, on school supplies. Look in the newspaper to see what might be out there. Look online before getting out so that you're taking advantage of the best deals. Shop when the sales are on. For example, if you're in the Ohio area, we do have tax-free weekend, and it actually starts tomorrow. Tax-free weekend is when stores will actually offer their items on sale to you without the cost of tax added on. So we're talking 6 to 7.5% savings already on top of what the savings may be. So if you were going to shop anyway, look for those opportunities to shop with deals, with sales, and with things like the tax-free weekend that's coming up in Ohio. I believe there's about 16 other states that participate in tax-free weekends. So look for those sales. The other thing with your budget is to go in with a plan and a budget and a spending limit, a boundary. Some of you know one of my favorite things to talk about when it comes to our spending plans is having goals and boundaries. Putting boundaries in a plan around how much you're going to spend and sticking to it. And again, thinking about what's a necessity right now. What am I going to need today for my children to be successful? And what am I going to need going forward? And really creating a spending plan that supports what you need with those things. My next tip for you would be as it relates to technology. I know a lot of people are trying to navigate the continued press for technology, the continued focus on technology. Some of your school districts may be providing laptops or Chromebooks and things of that nature, but you may be in search of a deal when it comes to the actual Wi-Fi or internet service that you're receiving. I do encourage you to look up, to research different options on Wi-Fi plans, and if there are different programs or discounts available to aid people with families. There have been programs out there that support individuals with children, lower income, low to moderate income families, as well as single moms. So check with your internet and service providers. Just ask, are there any resources or discounts available to me and my family to aid us in maintaining internet and wireless service? Because that may be a barrier to access for some families. And so it's important to address that. And even if it's not a barrier to access, if there's an opportunity for you to take advantage of a discounted rate or a rate that will help you to maintain that internet service at a better price for yourself, why not take advantage of it? Finally, when it comes to planning for your school supplies, even though I'm suggesting that you shop small and in smaller quantities and with necessities, I do recommend that you continue to include in your budget and savings plan money for future expenditures as it relates to back to school supplies. If you don't buy it now, you still can hold some of the money and save and put away each month a little bit of money for when your child may be going back into a full-time environment. Why do we want to do that? We want to do that for two reasons. One, we want to make sure we have the money accounted for so that it's there when we need it. And two, some of the supplies lists or the quantities that are may be needed when you do go back into a full in-person environment may be a little longer than they used to be. You may have more items on there to maintain and protect the welfare and safety of your children and the teachers. You may have more quantities of items needed, an option. And so because of that, we want to maintain a back-to-school budget ongoing this year. Instead of looking at it as once or twice, we want to maintain a small pot of reserves that will cover in case we need to make extra purchases, again, to not only supply our kids with the pencils and pens that they may need, but also with the safety and security supplies and hygiene supplies that may help them along the way. On that note, those are the tips that I have. Those are my 7 tips. I'm going to run right through them really quickly. Take inventory of what you already have was 1. Shop in small quantities and for necessities is 2. If you do shop in bulk, try to go into partnership with another family so that you can maximize the purchase. Take advantage of deals if you're going to shop, like the tax-free weekend that's coming up in Ohio this weekend, August 7th through the 9th. Use a budget and a spending plan so that you don't overspend when it comes to your budget. Number six was, as it relates to technology, look for and ask for discounts and programs that may help in sustaining online Wi-Fi or even your technology needs in those purchases. And number seven, finally, was even while you're shopping for today, to save a little bit for tomorrow so that you should have some money set aside for future purchases if and when your children go back into, or if they are now even in a full in-person environment, to make additional purchases that may come along with this pandemic environment, to not only keep our kids supplied, but also to keep them safe. So that is your finances in focus tip for this week. I want to thank you all that have joined and hopped on. If you have any questions, please feel free to type them in the chat box and ask them. We do have someone looking at those questions. I'm going to see if I can pull it up myself, actually. And for more back to school savings tips, please visit WPCU.coop. In our articles top section, we do have an article out there about smart ways to save. It is posted in the comment section of our box. And the other thing I wanted to share with you all is next week, if you are a parent, we are hosting a Building Savvy Student Savers webinar. It is next Tuesday, August 11th at 6 p.m. We will come back in and drop the link for that in the box. If you have a moment or two, join me for that webinar. I'm going to share with you some of my tips as a financial educator and savvy money mom about how to help build savvy student young savers, young money managers that will grow up to be strong money managers in adulthood. So please join me for that if you're available. We are going to start our Finances in Focus live series back up pretty consistently as we go into the fall. So you will hear from us at least every other week starting on Fridays. So thank you for tuning in, and please be sure to tune in again as we continue to bring our Finances in Focus around topics that are pertinent to today. If you have topics that you would like to suggest or things that you would like to hear from us on, please be sure to comment in the chat box. Please be sure to send us a private message. We want to make sure that the information we're bringing you is valuable and timely and pertinent to where you are today. I want to thank you all for joining me. I want to thank you all for being members. For those of you that are members, please feel free to share this message so that we can continue to get it along after it's posted. And again, if you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us at any time. Have a happy Thursday, and we'll see you back in a couple of weeks. Thank you.